Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
As we can see from your name badge, your name is Hannah.
Hannah.
And you emailed me about a question of some family-friendly masjids where iftar and people can sit together. And then I learned a little bit about Project Ramadan. But for people seeing this for the first time, what is Project Ramadan?
So Project Ramadan is a youth-driven initiative, and what we do is we build baskets of food for needy families in the GTA. So the baskets go to families of all different ethnicities, religions, not just for Muslim families. The baskets contain all the essentials for a family, so we've got rice, flour, sugar, and there's also meat, and it feeds a family of four for a month. And I think the most important part about our organization is that we're a youth initiative, so it's a really good opportunity for young people to get involved, to do something within their local community, and also have fun and make friends.
When you say young people, like, what's the age groups that have stepped up and become part of Project Ramadan?
So we've got a lot of people that are kind of like, they're entering into the workforce and they're leaving that university community and they're finding that they're not, you know, as connected with their local community. So it's kind of like, I would say 21 to like 30. We're constantly reaching, we'd like to get more high school students involved because we know there's great opportunity there for them to get involved. And we've also had kids come to our builds as well.
Kids?
Yeah.
What might their ages be?
So their ages tend to be from like 5 to 12, and they don't do the actual building. We also, at our previous build, we make cards that also go inside the basket, so it's more of a craft activity for the kids.
And they're not coming on their own initiative, they're coming because of the grown-ups, their parents.
Here, they find that their children are very sheltered, they have a really good life, and they like the kids to be more involved with, you know, what's going on beyond just my community and see, you know, not only good role models for themselves, but also, you know, what is going on, what are the problems, like people don't have food, we didn't know that happens in Toronto.
We're not in Toronto right now, we're in
Mississauga.
And where are we actually? We're in a parking lot, but where is this parking lot located?
So we're at the Muslim Welfare Center, they're our biggest partner. We're at Mavis and Central Parkway.
Where are the people coming here from? How far away or how close?
So we've got, the Muslim Welfare Center has, obviously here in Mississauga, and they also have another location in Scarborough. So people can go to either location. They're from all around the GTA.
This is called a build, what you're doing today. Where have you had other builds?
So the other build is in Scarborough.
At the
Muslim Welfare Center.
Okay. That's a little bit smaller than this location.
It's smaller in terms of the building, but the scale is a lot bigger because they have a larger space for us to work in. They have a really large warehouse.
So that might be the reason why you're under a tent and in the outside today.
Well, we're actually always under a tent because it gets really hot. So, I mean, today's a nice overcast day, but usually when, you know, it's sunny, our last week was 30 degrees. People are fasting, you know, we don't want them to overexert themselves.
Okay. Why is it called a build?
Because we're actually building the basket. So we've got all the supplies here, and what we're doing is putting the supplies into, well, it's not a basket, it's a bag, but we call it a basket.
Okay. How did Project Ramadan come about? Where did this idea...
In 2009, and it was a couple of friends who decided that they wanted to do something really great from the community, and they had heard of a similar initiative in the States, and then they thought, you know what, why don't we bring this to Toronto and do something local? So it started off with literally just 20 people building, and it's grown to we have over 100 volunteers who come. Our basket builder registration fills up within 15 minutes, and alhamdulillah, we've got really great support.
How many Ramadans has the project been going through?
So I believe this is the sixth one now.
Sixth?
Yeah.
So it's, for some reason, I never heard about this. Maybe I'm busy with my own travels with the 30 masjids.
Yeah.
How do people learn about this?
I think it's mainly word of mouth. You know, you come to a build and then you go home and you tell your friends and your family, hey, I did this awesome build today. It was so fulfilling. A lot of volunteers talk about how it's really fulfilling for them to be fasting and to give back. So I think it's a lot of word of mouth and also social media. We've got a great presence on social media.
Who's receiving these baskets?
So it's families of all, like I said, families of all different ethnicities, religious views. Some of them are single parent households. Some of them are dual parent households. They're a very diverse family structures.
As I learned, this is actually the final build this Ramadan. So what is going, you'll show me a few things, I'll go on a little bit of a tour in a few moments, but what is going on today?
Oh, so today we're actually building the basket. So what we do is we work with the Muslim Welfare Center who actually funds us. We buy all the supplies in advance. Then during the month of Ramadan, we do fundraising. And then a big part of our actual initiative is building the basket. So that's what's going on today behind me. You'll see volunteers opening boxes, putting them into the bags. And then we actually have two bags that are tied together that make one basket.
How many baskets like that might be created today, made today?
So today we're aiming for 250 over the whole Ramadan. We're going to be distributing 1,500.
1,500?
Yeah.
And that's to 1,500 families?
Yeah. Yeah.
So how many people might that assist or have an impact on, do you think?
The baskets typically feed a family of four, so 1,500 by four, 6,000. No. 6,000, is that right?
Yeah, that's right. 1,500
you got
times four.
My math.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So before we end this this segment, just the interview part, we go on the quick tour. Where may people learn a little bit more? The website and the social media are?
Yeah. So projectramadan.com is our website. Definitely check it out. Our Facebook page is facebook.com/projectramadan. We're also on Instagram and Twitter. So lots of different ways to connect with us. And you can always just drop us an email, info@projectramadan.com.
Okay, Sister Hannah, so we'll end this segment here and we'll go for a little tour.
What you can see here is we have four different teams assembling baskets. So we've got the bags over here, okay, then the bags are set up and open, and then the supplies are on this side, and what the volunteers are doing, as you can see, is taking the supplies and putting them in the bags. So we've got a checklist of items of what goes inside each bag, and so the volunteers are putting in those items into each basket. And then what happens is, once a basket is complete, we go over here, because it takes two bags to make a basket. So then the two bags are married together in the middle over here. So we have one bag from this team and one bag from the opposite team, and they come together and they're tied together.
Okay.
And then the bags are actually transported. So if we see these guys right here with the trolley, they're transporting the bags inside. And we take them into the warehouse for storage. And tomorrow, people will come to pick up the baskets.
Okay. So that...
this is our transport team. They're always working really hard. They probably have the most physically intensive job because they're taking the baskets and they have to sometimes retie and put them up on shelves. They have to find a way to organize
it. We'll take a picture of that later on.
Sure.
How many people are there here today?
I believe there's somewhere between 50 and 60.
50 and 60. So people are gathering the things on here, putting them in the bags. People are also doing likewise on the other side, a basket from each side, so it's like two assembly lines preparation lines. What's going on at the far end? It's the same?
It's the same thing, yep. So they've got it's just another station. Because we want to keep it organized, so yeah, just the other station there.
So if anyone wants to do this in their own city, or they're seeing this and they're being inspired to steal this idea, inshallah, and do a Project Ramadan, where they are, what would you tell them about this part? Because this is probably the harder part, is figuring all this out, the logistics. So what is it that you've learned, or you would do different when you started?
I think the biggest challenge for us is always donations. So people love coming to the builds because it's social, it's fun, you're meeting new people. I think the biggest challenge is always, can we get those donations?
There's a lot of organizations trying to fundraise during Ramadan. So we really rely on our volunteers to help fund these baskets. It's a big misconception as well, because sometimes our volunteers think that they're just coming and maybe Muslim Welfare Center donates the food or we get it donated, but actually we need to fundraise for it.
So that's a surprise. There is the fundraising.
Yeah.
That's the hardest part,
yeah.
More than this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like I said, our volunteers, we always have too many volunteers who want to sign up, and we always have to cap our registration to keep things organized. But we always have people who are like, oh, how can I volunteer? And it's just a function of the space that we have. We can't accommodate everyone.
There we are. Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to add? Or we've got a good overview.
I guess maybe just the one benefit a lot of the volunteers feel they get is that spiritual connection. Doing something really good.
So what just happened?
So they were just doing their team cheer.
A team cheer. What's a team? What's that?
So we do team building exercises when they first get here. So each team has a team name and a team cheer.
How many teams are here today?
There's four teams. There's five teams that are building, and then there's an audit team and also a transport team.
So this is very, very involved. Like, there's an operational excellence to this. It's not some, let's get together and, you know, kind of throw these baskets together. Like, you really figured out what you're doing.
Yeah, and we've tried assembling them in different ways over the years to see what works best. So it's a constant evolution for us.
There it is. Okay.
Do you want to ask when the teams to do their cheer again? Do you want to?
Well, that's a good idea. Maybe we'll just wait for it to be organic.
I don't know when they're going to do it again.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum.
And left to right, who are we speaking with today?
I'm Sada.
Michelle.
And I'm Farah.
And where are we?
We're at the Muslim Welfare Center, and we're building Ramadan baskets with Project Ramadan.
And why do you, the three of you, decide to spend your Saturday, it's one of the last Saturdays in Ramadan here, when you could be praying or doing other stuff? I'll start with Sister Sada.
I think it's really important to always give back to the community, and we're blessed as individuals, we should always share our blessings with others.
Give back, what does that mean to you?
Giving back to others, I find, is, you know, doing things that will be beneficial to them. So it could be as simple as maybe cleaning up after them, or even, you know, making food baskets for them.
Making food baskets. Is this your first Ramadan with the project?
Yes, it is.
And how have you found the experience?
I've actually found it really great. I enjoy that it's a bunch of young people really cutting together. We all have, I think, similar objectives, and it's fun at the same time. So you're giving back to the community, and you're helping each other, and having a good time at the same time.
And is that important, having fun in Ramadan?
I think it's always good to have a balance, especially when you're like younger. I find that having a fun component to something is always adding to it, or, you know, it, yeah.
Okay. Sister Michelle?
Yeah.
Fun. Is this fun?
It's a lot of fun, and I think it's the good kind of fun, and that's the thing about Ramadan that people sometimes confuse, and they think that just because you're fasting, you can't go out and do something good. But this is a great way to meet lots of people, and like she said, give back to the community, and in that you're helping people, but you're also having a good time, and that's important to remember, I think.
Okay, and Sister
Farah.
Farah. Did you know Sister Michelle and Sadaf before?
No, actually, we bonded through Greatest Breakers. No, I didn't. And it's, again, like, it's a great way to meet people, right? Like, I haven't met them before, and now we're building baskets.
So you've known each other for just a few builds or a few days?
No, this is the first build that I've actually been to. So this is the first time I've actually ever met him. And I think everyone kind of hits here.
You guys hit it off. Like, you're like best friends or something, right? This is your first build.
Yes.
So you've just been here a few hours, something like that?
Yeah, I came at 10:30 sharp, because that's what the email said. Gotta be on time. But and honestly, it's been great from start to now.
Okay, there are people watching this who, they're not quite sure. They're watching the video, they're learning, they're seeing a few photographs on the blog post. What were you expecting before you got here?
I was actually just expecting to give back, because I think that's really important. Like these two lovely ladies have touched on it, but it's, you know, we sometimes get so consumed with fasting and how it affects us and just our bodies, but at the same time, you know, we're not alone in this world, and there's so many other people going through fasting that don't have food, that don't have a big community to go to. So it's just a really good feeling to give back.
Oh, it's okay. Tangent, yeah. You were looking for something to do, like, or some way to give back?
Yes. That was like my personal goal this Ramadan, because before it's always been like my family, which I love, don't get me wrong, but I kind of wanted to go a little deeper into Ramadan and explore more of like giving back in the community, because that's an important part of our religion, is to give back. So that's kind of where this spawned from, and that's why I kind of sought it out. And I also had a really great friend who, unfortunately, she was too late to sign up. I feel so bad, but I found it out from her. So it was kind of nice to have that kind of social media to have this advertised and out there.
That's how you found out about Project Ramadan?
Yes. Yeah, so it was kind of great. I went to the Studio 89 social, and then from there it was, I want to be a part of the build. So it was just a matter of choosing which one.
So you're starting to allude to it on the tangent.
Yeah.
If Project Ramadan didn't exist, or you didn't find out about it,
right,
what might you have felt you lost this Ramadan 2014?
Hard to speculate, because I think I would have become more involved in the ISNA food bank. But at the same time, I think this is also a great, fun way of meeting people and giving back. And it's just a community aspect that I would have missed. Like, I would have missed out on meeting these lovely ladies,
right,
and all of the community that's here present. And it's great to see familiar faces from other socials. Like, there was a fundraiser for volleyball before Ramadan started, and to see those faces again, like, I think I would have missed all of that, right? Just like the community bonding. So yeah, that's definitely what I would have missed.
Okay. Sister Michelle, is this your first build?
Yes, this is my first build.
As well. So you might echo some of the statements a moment ago.
Sorry.
So if you weren't doing Project Ramadan, what might you be doing to give back, as has been said?
I think kind of similar to what she said, I would have been looking for other initiatives, because that was one of my personal goals as well. Ramadan isn't just only about fasting for yourself and just, you know, kind of doing the spiritual thing, but it's also about kind of realizing the blessings that we have and then making sure that we share those with the other people in need. And so I would have tried to find other initiatives that I could get involved in.
Has anything surprised you this morning? Wow.
I think it is like the sheer amount of stuff that we're doing right now, and the amount of food that the welfare center has been able to collect. We have so many baskets. If you take a picture of them, it's insane. Yeah. And the kind of people that come out, everyone is so nice and friendly and genuinely wants to help and share, and it's just amazing. Yeah. And I think also just on the part of the welfare center themselves, the fact that they arranged this and they've done 3 builds like this, it's amazing, amazing.
Yeah. Okay. Sister Sadaf, if Project Ramadan wasn't your project this morning, this afternoon, what would you be doing to give back?
I think I would just be scouring the community, not necessarily just for like Muslims, but you know, anything I could do to give back to the community. So if that's helping at food banks, you know, going to community centers, helping people that, you know, need it, basically, helping the needy in any way, that's what I would try to aim to do.
Okay, Sister Sadaf, Michelle, and Baro.
Sorry, my hair.
It's okay, yeah. Thank you very much for taking a few moments from the building of the baskets. So I better let you get back to giving back.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Neil, and I've been part of Project Ramadan now for the last 4 or 5 years. So when I first started with Project Ramadan, I actually heard of it just through word of mouth through one of my friends. And you know, we came out to the Muslim Welfare Center in Scarborough, and you know, it was just a bunch of us that kind of didn't really have a good process as to how we're doing things, and we kind of just figured it out as we went. So over the last 4 or 5 years, I've seen a significant change into, you know, obviously there's a lot more volunteers now that we see, and you know, you guys clearly can tell that we actually have to turn away volunteers. And even just with respect to processes, I feel like now things are a lot more streamlined, a lot more efficient. You know, we can make more bags in a smaller period of time. I think also from like a supply standpoint, we actually have a lot more different supplies than we used to have. And I think we've learned a lot over the years as to how the different you know, the different weights of the bags. Even, you know, one year I remember we actually the bags were too heavy, and so a lot of them broke. So just, you know, it's trial and error, and it's been it's something I look forward to every Ramadan, because you know, during Ramadan it's some you know, you get extra blessings for volunteering and charity work, and so it's just a good way to, you know, connect with other Muslims, connect with other young people, because you know, Ramadan it's difficult, and it really helps to know everyone else is going through the same thing.
So this is part of your Ramadan now.
Yeah, it's part of my Ramadan.
So if this wasn't here, what would you miss? What would you lose?
I would lose just the community. The community. I would lose the community. I would lose probably just the interaction with the others. Yeah.
So here we are today. It's the last, second last Saturday, but it's the last build of this Ramadan this year. How are you feeling on this day? What's going through you?
You know, my wife and I were driving in this morning, and we were talking about the last 10 days and how in the last 10 days when you give charity or you take your time out to do charity, you get extra barakah. And so I'm just thinking about that, and you know, how, you know, inshallah, this, you know, all the people that are here are gaining a lot from this, right? And not only are they gaining, but they're giving to others. So that's kind of what's going through me right now.
Okay. Maybe last question, or sort of the last question. You've been involved, you're not one of the founders.
No.
But you've been involved early on.
Yes.
And how might this have changed you? How have you seen changes in yourself over the one Ramadan, the next year, the following year?
I think it just helps. It probably helped me become more charitable and to have probably a greater sense of community within the, you know, the Muslim community in the GTA, which I don't think, you know, I felt like I had, and I think this has really brought that out.
So it's an entryway. It's a
think so.
Into the wider Muslim community.
I think so.
It sounds like if I have to put a word, of belonging, like it's.
Yeah.
You're able to feel that now?
Yeah, I feel like that, yeah.
If there was somebody watching this for the first time and it's a little bit hesitant, well, it's a lot of work and I don't want to do this, what might you tell them or share with them?
Well, we make it really fun. And so because it's fun, the day goes by quick and you're going to be tired, but at the end of the day, honestly, you feel really good about yourself. And it's very fulfilling.
Okay, Brother Neil,
thank
you very much, and for Ramadan Mubarak.
Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
And your name is?
Hassan.
And are you one of the founders?
So yes, I am, along with a whole bunch of other people. I was one of the founding members of Project Ramadan. We got it started about 6 years ago. And as you can see today, in our sixth year, we have a huge turnout. And amazing to see the whole community get involved with this initiative.
So that's today, but back then, did you have any idea it might become like this?
So I'll tell you the story behind this. The first year, we're coming out of university, a whole bunch of guys, we want to do something interesting. And instead of doing something from scratch, we knew if we found an organization that was doing good work, we could align ourselves with them and bring the youth out. That was our big focus, the three or four of us. So we started working with the Muslim Welfare Center. We said, hey, listen, during Ramadan, everyone wants to get out and do stuff. We'll start doing this. First year's goal, 50 baskets. What did we end up doing? 150. Wait a second, we've got some traction with this thing, right? Second year, increase that. 250, 550, 850, 1150, and mashallah, this year, we're on track to do 1,500 baskets for families. So that's 1,500 families getting food packages in the month of Ramadan.
Let me just go back a moment, back to the beginning. What other projects did you consider to fulfill that requirement that you had at the beginning?
At the beginning, so prior to that, we'd done something similar where we'd organized an amazing race for a bunch of our friends. About 100 people ended up coming out, and whatever funds we raised after registration fees, we donated all of it to the food bank. And that's where we knew we wanted to come in and physically do something. It's one thing to write a check or do a donation online. It's quite another feeling to show up during Ramadan, you're in that spirit, and put food in baskets together and know that this food is going out to families. So that was one of the main ideas behind what we wanted to do.
Your partner, and that is the word, is the Muslim Welfare Center.
Yes.
And they have two campuses, perhaps, as a word now.
Yeah.
Scarborough and here today in Mississauga. Are you from Mississauga or are you from Scarborough?
So I pretty much grew up in Mississauga, which is why, obviously, initially we started off in Scarborough, but MWC wanted to make sure that this campus also got a lot of recognition. And being from Mississauga, it's easier to get up in the morning and drive 5 minutes to the build. As sure. opposed to an hour to the build. Not that I mind that hour to the build, but it's great. And I think the turnout, especially here today this year, this is our second year of doing it at the Mississauga campus. And our turnout here speaks volumes about the community and the volunteer involvement that is present here in Mississauga and that can be leveraged for bigger causes and more causes.
This is a hard thing to do. You need a lot of volunteers, a lot of coordination. So from being one of the co-founders, the initiators, you've done different roles over the different Ramadans. What's some of the roles that are that you've played and, you know, is important, is needed?
Yeah, definitely. So fortunately, the good thing is we've evolved over time. So the first year it was an ad hoc thing. If something wanted to get done, you assigned to someone else. But we've become more of a structured organization. We have people that work at sourcing supplies with vendors to get better deals for our supplies. We have people that focus on the marketing end, whether it's brand management or social media marketing. We have two separate roles for that. We have people that are volunteers on the executive team that focus just on the bill day operations, how the flow of work is going to go. So stuff has evolved over time. Looking forward to next year. We've had a lot of interest from other organizations to partner up with us. So maybe it's a space for us to manage those relationships. We're also looking at doing events outside of Ramadan, now that we have a volunteer base that is engaged. So we're looking at doing events in December, in January, in March.
Well, then it's not Project Ramadan, is it?
Exactly, but that's what we want to try to get across. The same way that we start getting more involved and getting in touch with our spirituality in Ramadan, how about we extend it for the rest of the year? That's the idea of Ramadan itself, right? It's an opportunity for you to sit back, analyze, and then take it on for the rest of the year. So we're in the same boat. We've reached a point where, like, listen, we know we've done some good stuff in Ramadan. Let's take that and expand it over the rest of the year. And it's still very in the initial stages. We'll see how it goes. But the volunteer turnout speaks about people want to do something.
Others have talked about giving back. The original project that inspired you, the model, if you will, is there something that they can actually now draw from your experience here? Because you've grown in parallel, perhaps. What surprised you, maybe?
Could you explain that?
You got this idea from somewhere else.
Yeah, definitely.
And you've now made it your own. You adapted, innovated. What might you share with them? that you've learned along the way to improve their operations?
So definitely. So we've had a very open conversation with other groups across North America that are doing similar initiatives. We actually are closely aligned with Dallas, for example. There's a Project Ramadan Dallas that happens. And one of our friends in Dallas loved what we did over here, and they decided to start it up over there. So it's like their second year. And we have a communication where we learn from them, they learn from us. Outside of that, we've had other groups that are not maybe doing a Project Ramadan initiative, but a very similar idea in Buffalo, in Houston, and in New York. So we have those conversations with them across North America to learn, hey, maybe you guys are doing better on social media. How are you doing things better? So that dialogue really helps us to learn more about different spaces. So that's been really helpful for us.
So it's a knowledge transfer, knowledge sharing, an increase. Bring it back home to Canada. What other Canadian groups or have expressed any interest or curiosity?
Definitely. So this year we've had interest from Ottawa, we've had interest from Montreal, Edmonton, and Vancouver. So in the off season, which is post Ramadan, we'll sit down with them. We've created a quick document that outlines how it is that we run our operations, and it's more like guidelines. Because every city is going to have their whole volunteer, they're going to come up with some new ideas, they're going to innovate, but a guideline helps you get started. And lets you know that, you know what, it's not that hard as you might make it out to be. And it doesn't always, this is 6 years later, this is not year one. Year
right.
one was 30 people doing it. So 6 years later, we're blessed to have people that range in the vicinity of about 100 volunteers come out for every bill, which is amazing. We have to turn people away just because capacity is an issue. You build upon it slowly by slowly and go from there. So we're going to have that knowledge sharing experience.
So people who are younger would understand the term open source.
Definitely.
And this, you've given an open source description.
Definitely. We're not asking for any franchise fees. We're not asking for any kind of kickbacks. It's a very open source concept. We all love doing it because it's a good cause. It makes us feel good at the end of the day, maybe. And we know we're making some kind of dent in the community in terms of making a change. And if others want to, sure, we'd love to talk about it.
Okay.
So if you're out there watching, we'd love to talk to you about this.
All right. And how can they get in touch to have that conversation?
The best thing is reach out to us at info@projectramadan.com. That's the best email to get us to get in touch with us.
Okay. And just because we're here and there's no reason not to, the social media or other website address, just say
sure.
them.
Sure. So our Facebook page is facebook.com/projectramadan. You can catch us on Twitter at @project_Ramadan.
Okay, Brother Hassan. Thank you for sharing some minutes with us, actually quite a few minutes, but it's they're important.
Perfect.
So Ramadan Mubarak.
Ramadan Mubarak to you as well. I appreciate this. Thank you.
And happy bill day.
Happy bill day. Thanks.
I would just urge everyone to donate more. It's a good cause, and it doesn't even go out to just Muslim families, but it goes out to families all across different races, different nationalities, and honestly, it's great, and I've enjoyed myself every year, which is why I keep coming back. So, yeah.
That's great. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. Your name is?
Habiba.
And I understand you've been at all of the bills?
Yes, so from build one to the last one, which is build number three, I've been to all of them.
So let's start at the first one. How was that experience? How did that go for you?
The first build was in Scarborough, the first two bills. So the first build was a lot smaller. I've been to all of them. Usually we get a large crowd or a large number of people. But honestly, it was a lot of new faces we saw coming out for the first time, and just having the awareness that more people are hearing about Project Ramadan felt really good. We got our goal accomplished. I think we had 600 baskets filled in the first one, so it was great. And the weather was amazing.
So you were outdoors?
Yes, we were outdoors, yeah. At the Muslim Welfare Center, but the Scarborough location.
Scarborough.
Yep.
So there was a tent like...
Just like this one, yep. Same tent, same... It wasn't the same outline. We were trying something different, so each team had to do bag A and bag B. This year, just for the second and third build, we kind of had to revamp and stuff. So each team on the second and third build does just bag one, like bag A. And you put the two bags together.
You put them together.
Yeah.
So that was the first build
yep.
of this room. Then how did the second one go?
The second second one, alhamdulillah, we actually got a lot more people. It was, I believe, it went up on the morning of the second build, and we were at capacity within like 3 hours. So mashallah, a lot of people signed up, and it was great to see new faces again. Some of the people that were returning. It was a lot bigger built. We accomplished our goal again, and it felt great to give back and be a part of the community and interact with people from not only Scarborough, Mississauga, Toronto.
Mississauga, which is where we are today. You've just wrapped up the last build. And so this is like the end chapter or the conclusion.
Yeah. Yeah.
So how do you feel the experience, has sense of completion or something?
It feels amazing, alhamdulillah. It feels like you don't feel like you're making a difference, but when you've accomplished and when you look back at everything and what we've accomplished, it feels we're gonna make a difference for a lot of people, not just Muslims, but it goes out to non-Muslims as well. So it feels good. It's a proud moment. It's to be a part of Project Ramadan and to be coming back every year and doing it a lot more efficiently and raising a lot more money, which is what I want to urge as well. It feels great.
All right, Sister Habiba, thank you very much, and Ramadan Mubarak.
You too. Thank you so much, and Ramadan Mubarak to everyone as well. If you want to throw up a thumbs up or something, go for it. Have fun with it. You're looking at this camera.
Well, let's find the start.
I will. So one, on three. One, two. Okay, one more time. They cut the podcast. Okay. Yes, Eid Mubarak. So wow. On three, one, two.
Eid Mubarak!
Thank you so much. We are very close to 250 baskets now, so we're actually done for the day. So thank you guys so much again. So keep in mind, we've reached our goal in terms of building baskets, but we still need to do a lot of fundraising. So like Hannah said, you know, get the word out, post up on social media. All of you who got the volunteer email have some sample messaging in there, as well as a donation email that you can use. So please send it out to your networks. Feel free to take some postcards if you want. You can see either Hannah or Hannah for some postcards. And yeah, thank you again. If we can get, we need maybe 10 people who can stay behind to just help clean up and do a little bit of transport. So if you can stay behind, I'm going to ask you to come see me over here in just a minute, but kind of have something final to say.
Yeah, so we'd love to have you stay. We did ask you to stay until 3 o'clock initially. I know we're done early, but if you can stick around for a bit just to help out. I'm going to pass it over to Rehan. He just has a few more announcements. And please, before you leave, make sure that you give your name tag to us if you do have to go. Last thing, if you guys are involved in anything, like if you have any of your own charitable events on the side, or if you're involved in something with an iftar or at your mosque, whatever it may be, if you have any ideas for us, we're always looking for fresh ideas, especially if it'll bring in donations in these last 10 days. So we're open to your ideas, so please let us know.
Okay, once again, thank you very much for being here at Muslim Welfare Center Mississauga branch and helping us in getting another 250 bags or all together 1,500 bags of food hampers. So today we have a special guest, Brother Rafiq Rokhriya. He's a judge from Citizen and Immigration Center. Brother Rafiq Rokhriya, you want to say something?
Thank you, mashallah. Alhamdulillah, I'm very much pleased that you all giving your volunteer time. You will be rewarded here and hereafter. Allah will accept you, inshallah. Good day. Thank you very much. Excellent. Keep it up, and I'll be very proud of you. Okay. Give yourself a big round of applause. Special to all of you. Thank you. Thank you. Delighted to be here.